थोड़ा पानी पी लो। Coming to the route plan, well, the route plan I'm going to give you is keeping in mind that we have a very few leaves in hand and we are going to ride fast and steady, but not very fast. Okay, well, if you're planning to ride from Kolkata to Leh to Kolkata, then it's going to be complete in about 19 to 21 days, 19 days to be precise. And you can take 2 days as buffer just in case the weather turns bad, the roads are closed for some reason. So it's better to keep 2 days in buffer. Now talking about the first part, that is Kolkata to Delhi. Kolkata to Delhi is around 1500 kilometers, but you are going to cover this route in 2 days. For any day of the ride, I would suggest you to start as early as possible. Keep it less of a leisure ride and more of a ride where your target is Delhi. That is, try to take short breaks, try to waste less time if possible. Do not take too much of photographic breaks. Well, I'm not suggesting you to enjoy the ride. Definitely enjoy the ride. Take it as per your pace, as per your body allows you to, as per the conditions around allow you to. Last thing is keep the plan dynamic. So during your trip from Kolkata to Delhi, there are actually 3 places where you can stop: Varanasi, Allahabad and Kanpur. The distance from Kolkata to Varanasi is 700 kilometers. From Kolkata to Allahabad, it's around 800 kilometers, and from Kolkata to Kanpur, it's around 1000 kilometers. Now, the distance from your highway to your hotel in Varanasi is approximately 15 to 20 kilometers. The distance from the highway to your hotel in Allahabad is approximately 30 to 40 kilometers, and the distance to your hotel from the highway in Kanpur is around just 2 or 3 kilometers. Given those figures, do remember that the time taken from the highway to your hotel in Varanasi would take around 30 minutes, and next day also you would need another 30 minutes to come back from your hotel to the highway. So that means you need 1 hour extra if you are thinking of halting at Varanasi. Now coming to Allahabad, in case of Allahabad, since it's around 30 to 40 kilometers away from the highway, you would need around 45 minutes from the highway to your hotel in Allahabad, and you would need another 45 minutes next day to come back from your hotel in Allahabad to the highway. So that means you would be wasting around 1.5 hours to 2 hours just to travel from the highway to your hotel in Allahabad and to come back the next day. Regarding Kanpur, as the hotel is only 2 or 3 kilometers away from the highway, so it becomes very easy to travel to your hotel, to check into your hotel from the highway and then check out and start the journey continuously. I have already suggested you to start as early as possible, but given these figures, if you are able to reach Varanasi from Kolkata within around 2 to 4 PM, then I would suggest that you can move ahead and target to stay at Kanpur or Allahabad. Now Allahabad is a place where I would say only if you don't have any option, do stay here, because as I've already shown you, wasting 2 hours to go to your hotel in Allahabad and coming back, it's completely unnecessary. So if you're not halting at Varanasi, try to go and move ahead and halt at Kanpur, because Kanpur is once again the best place, because number one is that on day one your energy level will be pretty high, so you might as well use it by riding straight 1000 kilometers to Kanpur. And checking into the hotel in Kanpur is much easier because you're not wasting much time to ride from the highway to the hotel. My suggestion would be not to take it too hard and stay back at Varanasi. That way you would have a comfortable ride on both the days, on day 1 and day 2. So on day 2, if you are starting from Varanasi, it's around 800 kilometers more to Delhi. So I would suggest start a bit early. If you halted in Kanpur on day 1, then obviously you can take it easy on the next day, because from Kanpur to Delhi, the roads are awesome. You are going to get the Lucknow Agra Delhi Expressway, which is once again one of the best roads in the country. From the road perspective, if you are halting at Kanpur on day 1, day 2 becomes a butter smooth and easy day. So do stop at a place which suits you, and as I already said, keep the plan dynamic. Do not fix your mind from beforehand that you will be stopping at Varanasi or you will be riding straight to Kanpur. Take it as the day goes, as per the conditions around you arise, as per your body copes up with the heat around and everything around. I would suggest you go accordingly. And on day 2, you would be riding either 800, 700 or 500 kilometers to reach your destination, that is Delhi. When you reach Delhi, try to take your hotel near Karol bagh. That is a place where you would probably change your engine oil and get your motorcycle checked a bit. So that's about the route in short from Kolkata to Delhi. speaking about the overall road conditions, the roads are in general superb and great, but in certain places like Varanasi and in certain places in Bihar, the roads might be a bit congested on the highways, national highways as well. There might be some hefty traffic. So apart from that, the roads are absolutely good. And talking about the roads from Agra to Delhi or Kanpur onwards, the roads are absolutely splendid. I mean, those are one of the roads. The Yamuna Expressway or the Agra-Delhi Expressway is a treat to ride on. That's a lifetime of an experience if you're going to ride on those roads. Yeah, you don't need to worry about the routes, roads, neither do you need to worry about fuel pumps, because there are a lot of them, plenty of them on the way. So that's about the road in short from Kolkata to Delhi. And if you are planning to visit Taj Mahal in Agra as well, then I would say instead of doing Kolkata to Delhi in 2 days, take 3 days time. Devote some day to Agra. After riding from Kolkata to Varanasi, ride from Varanasi to Agra, travel around Agra, ride around Agra, go to Taj Mahal, visit Taj Mahal, and then ride back to Delhi. So do it in 3 days if you are planning to include Agra in that as well. The day after you reach Delhi, I would suggest you to rest at Delhi, because that is necessary to gain back some of your energy. Well, it depends from person to person, depending upon how much you can take, how much journey you can take. But I would suggest you to take a day rest at Delhi before you start riding towards Leh, because Leh is actually your destination, not Delhi. So you should gather up some energy and then start riding towards Leh. So that rest day will also be the day when you can get your motorcycle checked once again, change the engine oil or do whatever extra stuff that you need to do. That's about the route from Kolkata to Delhi. The ride will definitely be fun and awesome, and I specifically suggest all my audiences to ride from their home straight from Kolkata, go to Leh and ride back, because that trip altogether has a totally different kind of experiences. I mean, riding right from your doorstep to Khardongla or to Ladakh, to all the places in Ladakh, and coming back to your doorstep, that's a completely different feeling altogether. So if you can do that, if your leaves permit that, if your budget permits that, then I would say just do that. The next leg of the journey would be from Delhi to Leh, probably via Srinagar, because that's the route we would prefer in case if there is not much unrest there, and in case everything is fine there, then definitely Srinagar is the route to go through, travel towards Leh, because choosing the Srinagar route lets you acclimatize properly. So if you are traveling from Delhi to Leh via Srinagar, so on day one you are going to ride from Delhi to Pathankot, which is around 480-ish kilometers away from Delhi. In between also you get some major stops like Jalandhar, Ludhiana, Chandigarh. So in case if you are not comfortable in riding that far, so you might as well halt in any one of these places. Day 5 you can ride from Pathankot to Srinagar or Sonmarg, which is around, if it's Srinagar it's around 350 kilometers, and if it's Sonmarg it's around 430 kilometers. So if the conditions in Srinagar are absolutely fine, then you can halt at Srinagar, enjoy the Dal Lake even for a day there, and then head towards Leh. But if there is some unrest going on, or if you are not comfortable staying back at Srinagar, then you can ride straight ahead to Sonmarg, which is around 430 kilometers away from Pathankot. Day 6, I would suggest you to ride straight from Srinagar or Sonmarg to Leh, which is around 420 kilometers from Srinagar or 340 kilometers from Sonmarg. On the way, do not miss the war memorial at Kargil. So that's about it. Apart from that, the roads till Leh are absolutely awesome. You would definitely enjoy the roads there. Apart from the Jojira Pass, which becomes a little bit adventurous but interesting and enjoyable as well. So that's in short from Leh to Srinagar. Upon reaching Srinagar the next day, I would suggest you to acclimatize yourself, give time to roaming around Leh city or getting your permits done. That's how day 7 should end. If in any case the unrest at Srinagar continues, and going by the news and all, you are not comfortable riding through Srinagar, then you can always ride through the Manali route, which is once again one of the best adventurous and most beautiful routes out there. If you are going to choose the Manali route, one of the things is that do not rush, enjoy the beauty, take it slow and steady, and yes, extra fuel. From Manali to Leh, there is a certain stretch where most of our motorcycles with fuel tanks ranging from 10 to 15 liters, many of our motorcycles won't last for that stretch. So yes, carrying a bit of extra fuel is necessary. In my case, I did carry around 6 liters of fuel, but I did not need that much. So yeah, if you have just 1 5-liter jar with you, that would suffice. So after your resting day at Delhi, on day 4 you're going to ride from Delhi to Manali, which is around 540 kilometers. The traffic while entering Manali would be quite heavy. So if in case you are not comfortable riding to Manali straight away, there are a lot of places where you can stop in between. For example, Chandigarh, Bilaspur, Mandi, these are the places where you can get ample hotels to stay. So you can break it up in 2 days if you want, and if you have that spare time. The next day would be the day when you start your ride from Manali and head towards Leh. You don't need to fill your jerry can when you are starting from Manali, because on the route from Manali to Leh, Tandi is the last petrol pump where actually you can fill your tank to the brim and also fill your jerry can. So do not worry about fuel while leaving from Manali. On day 5, I would suggest you to ride from Manali to Jispa or Sarchu. I do not suggest Sarchu in general, because Sarchu is at a very high altitude, and riding straight from Manali to Sarchu can give you a bit of AMS problems. Well, if you are on Dymox, you are probably a bit safe, but everyone's body does react differently. From Manali to Leh, these are the list of places where you can halt. But I would suggest you to ride from on day 5 from Manali to Jispa, and on day 6 from Jispa to Leh directly. Just in case if the weather is not that good, you can also cover the distance from Manali to Leh in 3 days instead of doing it in 2 days. So in that case, take one of the halts at Jispa, take the second halt at Sarchu, and ride towards Leh the next day. That makes the ride easier and more enjoyable. So I would suggest you can do that as well. Once again, the day after you have reached Leh, that is on day 7, I would suggest you to stay at Leh, acclimatize yourself, if needed get the permits done. Okay, if not, you could take your time to travel around the city of Leh as well. Well, abhi tak to half of the journey is also not complete yet, but you did just ride from Kolkata to Leh, which is a great thing in itself. Now comes the main part, that is riding around Ladakh. Well, truly speaking, Ladakh is a big place, and there are lots of places to enjoy in Ladakh. If you have ample time, I would suggest you to stay at each place and enjoy the essence and beauty of those places. Lekin jaise ki hum logo ke paas chuttiyon ki hamesha kami rehta hai, that's why the main places of Ladakh where you should visit are, number one, the Nubra Valley via Khardungla and the Pangong Lake. So these are the most common places in Ladakh that everyone visits when they visit it for the first time. As I already said, Ladakh is a big place, and there are various other places like Hanle, Somuriri, Zanskar Valley. So there are a lot of other places to visit in Ladakh, but these are the two most beautiful places among all the others. So yeah, if you're visiting Ladakh for the first time, go ahead for Nubra and Pangong Lake. So yes, on day 8, you can ride from Leh to Nubra Valley, crossing Khardungla. And there in Nubra Valley, you can stay in Diskit, which is a small town there. In Diskit also, there is a petrol pump, but then the petrol pump there is not always open, and petrol is not available there at all times. So do ensure that you have your tank full when you're leaving Leh. On day 9, you can ride from Nubra Valley back to Leh, but before riding back from Nubra Valley or Diskit to Leh, do visit the Hundar sand dunes, because there are double humped camels there. And that is the only place in India where you can find double humped camels. It is not necessary that you carry all your luggage from Leh to Nubra and then bring all your luggage back. Instead, you can talk with the hotel guy and keep your heavy saddle bags back at your hotel at Leh, and carry only the necessary things that would need for a single day ride to Nubra Valley and come back. So that way you can travel lighter, and crossing Khardungla would be much easier for you. So on day 9, when you have come back from Diskit to Leh, covering a distance of around 120 kilometers, on day 10, you can ride from Leh to Pangong Lake, which is around 160 kilometers, crossing Changla Pass. So yes, in this case also, I would suggest to keep your heavy luggage back at your hotel and just carry some of the essential things that you need for a one-day trip to Pangong Lake and back. And that way your motorcycle would be light and it would not cause much problems at high altitudes. So while crossing Changla Pass, it's better if you have a light motorcycle. On day 11, after you have enjoyed Pangong Lake, you would probably be staying at places like Spagmik, Man or Merak. Spagmik is around 160 kilometers from Leh. Man is another 10 kilometers from Spakmik, and Merak is another 10 kilometers from Spakmik. All these three villages are by the side of the Pangong Lake, so it's your choice where you want to halt. You do not need to pre-book any of the hotels at any of these places. You do not need to pre-book hotels at all. You can go there, find your own spot and then stay there. If necessary, you can also pitch your own tent and camp by the side of the Pangong Lake. And that's about it. On day 11, you are riding back from Pangong to Leh. Your first ride to Ladakh is thus completed. The next part is coming back from Leh to Delhi. If you have traveled via the Srinagar route to Leh, then you should try and choose the Manali route to come back from Leh. That way you would get to experience both these routes, and in case you have traveled from Delhi to Leh via Manali, try to take the route via Srinagar back. That way you could enjoy the Kashmir Valley as well. And as I already mentioned regarding your ride from Kolkata to Delhi, just make it vice versa, and while coming back from Delhi to Kolkata, halt at Kanpur or Allahabad or Varanasi, whichever place suits you. So that's in short about the route plan in Ladakh. Ladakh ki roads ke baare mein to kya batana, you have seen a lot of videos about the roads in Ladakh. So yeah, most of them are adventurous, most of them it's splendid, it's beautiful all around, but it's adventurous as well. So that's what we guys go there for, right? To have the adventure of our lives. So that's about it. So the next video I'm going to make on Ladakh is the budget or the cost of riding from Kolkata to Ladakh and back from Ladakh to Kolkata. So I have separated the budget accordingly, and in the next video I will explain every details about the budget to you guys. If you have not watched my Kolkata Leh Kolkata solo ride in 2017, there is the whole series out there on YouTube. Just head over to my channel, go to the playlist section, and that you can find the Ladakh playlist. Go ahead and watch it guys. I'm sure you'll get a lot of experience. You'll know about the do's and do nots from the whole series. So the series is in detail covering each and every day of the ride. So I would suggest you to go ahead and watch that series before embarking on your Ladakh ride. Apart from that, just wait for the next video. I am coming out with the budget details soon. If there is something more that you want to know about this Ladakh ride, do leave your questions in the comment sections below, and as always I will definitely reply back. That's about it guys. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, do not forget to hit the thumbs up button down below, and if you have not subscribed yet, do subscribe. Thanks for watching.